Good evening. So, excited to show you guys a new product. Well, not a new product, but a product I haven't shown you before. Joshua's been begging me to go ahead and make these potato chips. We have these wonderful microwave chip makers. They actually come in a set of two. And I use them singularly, but you can stack them and use them one stacked on the other in the microwave if you choose. You can do apple chips, you can do sweet potato chips. We're gonna do potatoes because that's what Joshua's been asking me for. So what I did, it's really simple, just took a potato and washed it real good so that it's clean. And then I'm gonna go ahead and use our 5-inch utility knife. If you don't have good quality knives in your kitchen, you might want to choose to get some real nice ones for the holidays, especially if you're the one that's going to be cooking or you're going to have people in your kitchen cooking. A sharp knife is your safest knife because you're not pushing as hard, so you're much less likely to get cut. So like I showed you before, you want to make sure you balance the knife in your hand. You're going to go ahead, unless it's a tiny paring knife, and you're going to pinch and wrap your three fingers around here. You have a lot more control on your knife. So we're just going to go ahead and cut our potato in half. And this one's kind of big, so I'm also going to cut a little part off of it here so that we can easily balance it. And then I'm going to use the simple slicer. And I've shown this to you before, so maybe you've seen it, maybe you haven't. But let's see here. I have it unlocked, and then we're going to put it on one to show it to you. So that's real thin. And then we're going to do two and three. So you can do three different slicing with it. But because we want to do potato chips, we have to have it paper thin. So we're going to go ahead and, I don't know if you guys saw that, this has rims on it. You see the little curves? And it fits onto this like that so that it, you know, can not come up. So let's say, put our half of potato in here. This has crumbs in it. So we're going to stick it into the potato. And then we're just going to do this. And it's super simple. It doesn't seem like you're really doing anything at all. But that's why I'm holding it up, because you want to make sure that you have space for the potato to go down. And I'm doing it over our cutting board. So see what we got here? Kind of exciting. We're going to get the rest of the potatoes done so that that part's taken care of. And if you're doing potatoes or apples, those can leave your brown residue on your slicer. So I just go ahead and rinse that off right away. So we'll do that. I have a lot of potato chips. Josh was going to be excited. He's gone for the evening. So when he gets home, I'll have a little treat for him. I think that'll make him happy. So we are done here. And with this whole mound of potatoes, potato chips. And I'm going to rinse this like I said, so it keeps it nice and white. And then I do close the blade up before I put it in my dishwasher because I don't want to get cut on it. So we've gone ahead, we have our potatoes. So what you do is take a piece of paper towel and slide this over here. I'm actually going to do it right here on the cutting board so you can see. Okay, so you're just going to take your potatoes and we're going to just line them out here. And on our piece of paper towel, because you do have to let them dry. They work a lot better that way. Okay. So we have our potatoes here. And then we're going to go ahead and, usually I have a towel behind me. We're going to go ahead and salt them. So I have our salt shaker here. And then we're going to take another piece of paper towel and we're going to blot them dry. sometimes I like to use the smoky applewood seasoning. This is really good on the chips. So now I am laying them out. I don't know if you can see this. So I'm just laying them out on the chip maker here. And every microwave is a little different. So when you do these the first couple of times, you're probably gonna have to just see how long you need to put this in the microwave for. We're gonna start out with 5 minutes and see how that works. And you want them, you don't want them overlapping because they'll stick together. So just kinda get them here. Okay. And we're going to go ahead and put this in the microwave. Set that for 5 minutes. And then I'm going to put the rest of these chips around on the other microwave chip maker there. So you don't want to watch me make all the rest of these. But while we're waiting for that to come out of the microwave, I just wanted to kind of give you guys some ideas. Believe it or not, we are fast approaching Christmas. And I know that sometimes, you know, getting those last minute Christmas gifts, whether it be for teachers or for your neighbor next door or whatever it might be, sometimes you need ideas and something. Sometimes it's nice to just have some around too. So I have a few ideas for you. So let me show you those while we're waiting for the potato chips to go ahead and be ready to go. So I have whole slew of ideas here. So first I have the microwave grips. Absolutely love these. So these are kind of fun little stocking stuffers. These are all gifts that are right around $10 or quite a bit less. The mini serving spatula, of course this could be attached to any gift. These are awesome. Be careful if you take them with you and to like any kind of an event, because if you don't label them, they might disappear. So okay, thank you, Tori. You can't see what I was doing with the potatoes. Okay, so what I did, let me see if I can show you guys this. I don't know why it's not down further, but here's a piece of paper towel, and I just laid the potatoes out on it, and then I went ahead and took our salt, our seasoning salt, and I just spread it out on that. Towel and just patted it dry. So then I removed the paper towel and I laid the potato chips out on the chip maker so that they were done there. And if you wanted, like I said, you could also use, this is the smoky applewood rub, but there's our barbecue rub, or be creative. You could use any kind of thing. We have a new ranch seasoning for our popcorn. That might be good too. I haven't tried that. So anyhow, and so here is the nylon mini serving spatula, and these are really cool if you do a lot of baking. This is nice if you're making cookies with a small scoop. This is a great one to use. Toaster tongs. Everybody loves toaster tongs. So these are great stocking stuffers too. Mini whipper. My mom loves these. You make hot chocolate with it. You can scramble eggs with it. You can do just all kinds of anything you need to just mix up real quickly. So there's the mini whipper. Ice cream dipper, who doesn't love ice cream? So this is another great tool. You know, put a little bow on it, attach a jar of hot fudge, maybe caramel, and you have a really nice little gift. We also have our little cleaning brush. If you have like somebody who you know loves to clean, this is really cool. It's got like bristles, kind of like a toothbrush, but I don't know if you can see there, slanted. And then it's got the cleaning part here on the end. It's a point. So that's another neat little idea there. And let's see here. I wanted to show you guys a couple of, those are stocking stuffer ideas, but I wanted to show you some of the other things. Obviously, I've been using our new salt and pepper mill. Lovely. This is a gorgeous gift. It's also a great wedding gift. I know there's lots of weddings around this time of year too. Let me grab a couple of things here. This is the new electric wine bottle opener. Now we still have our other wine bottle opener, which is awesome, but this one is brand new, and this is how you open the paper, but it also doubles as a stand. So it sits in here like this, and then it has a cord and you plug it in, and then you just push your buttons up and down. I don't have a bottle of wine, or I could show you how that works. You have to do that one time. These are labels. They come in a set of four. This one says October. It comes with chalk, and you can put these like on a wine bottle or label a gift. They're really nice. They're the ash wood with the little chalk wood board on the front. Those are fun. And that's one of the new products. You could also do the popcorn maker. I've shown you this before, but this is such a nice, cool gift. You want to get yourself one, get one for a friend or two, or even you might want to have a couple of gifts laid back in case you get a surprise gift from somebody so that you can go ahead and say, hey, oh, I have a gift for you too. And this is kind of universal. Most people love popcorn, and it's just a really neat tool to be able to have and give away. So that, just a couple of ideas there for you. Or you could, if you wanted to even kind of up the popcorn gift, we have the ranch seasoning I told you guys about, or this is the new French toast, which would be really great with our whipped cream maker. So let me grab this out of the microwave and show you what the chips are. So I know they look dark, but I actually like to make these darker because they taste better. And oh my gosh, they're so addicting. So just a warning when you're making these. And so I don't know if you guys can hear that, but I'm putting them in the stoneware bowl here and serving. But if I wanted to keep them, I always get this question. They never last overnight. Never, 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 ever. But let's say they did. If you wanted to keep them and store them, you could go ahead and use our glass, our leak-proof glass containers. And these are really neat. This is the small square, and then we have a medium square. And the lids go on. See the lid? Go on like this. And you just snap and snap. They're great for lunches. In fact, my reason I don't have the medium square is because it's at a friend's house for some food. So, wanted to show you guys, I got these out. This is the small rectangle and then the large rectangle. And this works great if you have like a lot of leftovers. And this one is, you know, if you don't have quite as many leftovers. Or you can freeze, you know, cook and then freeze so that you have stuff ready for another meal. So, just wanted to show you how to make these chips. I know Joshua's going to be ecstatic. And this is just maybe a quarter of the potato. So you can see how many chips you get. And it's super easy. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And I will be posting some other fun things later on. If you have questions, post them below. I'll answer them. If you would like to see a particular product demonstrated, or maybe you'd like to see a particular recipe demonstrated, let me know. I am happy to do that. Anything I can do to help make your life a little easier, love to do that. And you guys have a great evening. Thanks so much. Bye.